Hi, welcome to GarageBand. This is an Apple Macintosh software application which allows you to create or arrange music and podcasts. Here's a demo of a GarageBand composition using Apple Loops, which are pre-recorded music files. The first track is a bass line, followed by a drum track and a lead melody. Let's close the window and relaunch the GarageBand. To launch the GarageBand, click the guitar icon located in the dock. Click Create New Music Project. Save as class underscore name underscore index number underscore and type in BGM, meaning background music. Save in the student folder located in the left-hand column. Save in Sec1 Music folder, search for your respective class, and click the Create button. The project window shows a timeline, which contains the default grand piano track where you can record, play, or add the Apple Loops. You may also choose to mute or unmute the track. Solo the track if you wish to hear it more clearly, or adjust the track mixer volume of each track. Next, the playhead located in the bottom of the screen allows you to start or stop the playback, rewind, or fast forward. The beat ruler contains the bar numbers or measures. You may choose to minimize or maximize the bar numbers. The master volume allows you to adjust the overall volume of your project. Next, let's explore the Loop Browser or iView button located at the bottom left-hand corner of the window. Narrow your search by selecting the column view in the left-hand corner. The loops are arranged by genres, meaning the different musical styles, such as country music, or orchestral music, can also be categorized according to instruments, such as all drums, or guitars, or they can be differentiated according to moods. Click to preview the loops. And drag the selected loop to the timeline. A new track is created. Essentially, there are two types of Apple Loops: the green track or MIDI software loops, as well as the blue track, which are the real instrument audio loops. Now let's begin on our composing activity. Your task is to create suitable background music to attract the customers to a selected retail outlet. Select your Apple Loops or pre-recorded music files from the Looper browser. Select from the column view and preview the instruments. Once you've decided on which loop, drag and drop to the window. You can extend or shorten the track by placing your cursor at the end of the track. A hook will appear and you may extend or shorten the track by clicking or dragging the hook back and forth. You may also wish to delete the track by highlighting the track. Go to the drop-down menu, select track, and delete. If you wish to undo, go to edit, and undo the change. Now let's close this window. And reopen the demo track. Your composition should contain only three tracks, namely the bass line, meaning any bass line instruments, such as the acoustic bass, or double bass, or electric bass. Your next track should be a drum or percussion loop, which you may select from all drums, or the percussion loop. We selected the claves. All the shakers. And finally, your lead melody essentially means any melodic instrument which carries a tune, such as the guitar or keyboards. Remember to stagger the entries of each track so that they do not begin all at once. The length of the composition should be 16 bars in length. Add a fade out to your composition from the drop-down menu, select track, and click fade out. Remember to save your work regularly, and again, from the menu bar, select file, and click save. You are now ready to begin. Remember the loops which you select should match the ambience or mood of the shop or retail outlet. Have fun!